Hi, Internet. Happy Monday. Let's see, if the Friday before Easter is Good Friday, then that must make today Awesome Monday. So happy Awesome Monday, everyone. I hope the Easter Bunny brought all of you baskets of delicious treats, and if not, then I hope you were able to take advantage of day after Easter sales for tons of chocolate at low, low prices. So I have a hunch about how to find the last zone, and it's not a hunch at all. It's based on a comment that a viewer left. I don't remember which one it was. I'm sorry. Whoever you are, thank you for the tip. But they suggested that the purpose of this level is to ride the bubble all the way to the end, because this level was sort of confusing to me the first time I went through it. I rode the bubble through some of the level, but by the end of the level, I lost the bubble, so I was unable to get to the goal bell, the bell that you hit at the end of every level to get to the bonus stage. And a viewer left a comment to the effect that in order to get to the goal bell, you have to ride the bubble to the end of the stage. And I was like, oh, well, that makes sense. I should have thought of that the first time I played this level. And I was going to go back and try that, but then I realized, well, hey, maybe if you do go through the bell exit in this level, it doesn't just, like every other level, it doesn't seem to matter whether you get the bell or not. You go on to the next level regardless. But in this stage, I thought, what if it's different? What if this stage breaks all the rules? So here I am, I rode the bubble, I'm about to hit the bell. Let's see what happens. Man, that's a really satisfying way to end the level. I have one of those, bells that, like, you see on a hotel desk, except not really. It's like you see on a hotel desk in movies, where you hit it and it goes ding! I should just keep that by my desk. Alright, Space Zone. My hunch paid off. Thank you, viewer, for your help. But yeah, I should just keep that bell on my desk and just hit it every time I accomplish something in a game. You know, get that Pavlovian response. Okay. So, I'm in a space suit. Gravity is low. And my bunny ears are inoperable, which actually makes a lot of sense, because that sort of thing wouldn't work in a low atmosphere environment, because, you know, you need air to create lift. So that's actually realistic. I'm impressed. I wonder, no, you still can't do the spin jump, though. Even though you can't float, you do not get the spin jump ability back. I'm assuming those pigs are mechanical, which is how they're operating without any sort of protection or oxygen. Yeah, that thing looks pretty mechanical too. Both those enemies appeared in the clockwork level, which is why I'm assuming they are... Oh no! I jumped... Whoa. Mario doesn't look that much different in a spacesuit when he's tiny. Oh wait, I'm not tiny, I just lost my ears. Duh. Alright. I made a leap of faith and it paid off. Oh, even without the bunny ears, I still can't do a spin jump. That's interesting. But, you know, who needs a spin jump when I can jump 90 feet in the air? Come on, you jerk. Man. Aw, man. Well, maybe, oh. I should have just forgotten about the flower. Oh, well. So, yes. Tiny Spacesuit Mario looks like you would expect. This is pretty awesome, though. I was really not expecting this. I'm glad I saved this for last, because this is way more interesting than that dumb Mario level. I was all excited about Mario Zone. I thought it would be a Kafka-esque look into the bowels of my own psyche. But it was just a dumb, like, I mean, it didn't even look like anything on the inside. It was just gears and bugs and pigs. Which, you know, to be fair, I'm sure that's what Mario actually has inside him in real life. You know, the real life Mario. He is full of insects and pig products, pork products. Yeah, 1-up get. Awesome. Oh yeah, I should have gone back to the slot machine. Now that I have all these coins. Although, I should probably wait until I don't have almost full life. A full complement of lives. So this level is proving to be trickier than one would expect. The low gravity really messes with you. I mean, the jump physics already feel weird for a Mario game, and having the low grav in effect just makes it that much funkier. Aw man, I wonder if there's going to be like a VVVVVV style level where you can reverse gravity and walk on the ceiling. That would be pretty awesome. Sonic & Knuckles also had a similar level like that, where you can, it's a space level, it's the Death Egg Zone, which is like the space station in the Sonic universe, where you could reverse the gravity. That was one of the coolest Sonic levels of all time. Oh hey, I killed 100 enemies, nice. I don't think I'm ever going to get a 5 enemy combo with this. Aw man, so close. If I had hit that ball, then I would have gotten it. Oh well. I mean, it's just a 1-up. It's not like it's anything that special. Oh no. This is a big jump. Can I make this? Ooh, barely. This is very appropriate space music as well. Just kind of slow and dreamy and I was going to say relaxing, but it is a little shrill. Or maybe... Man, I was right at the end, too. Dang it. Maybe I just had my volume up a little too loud. It's kind of interesting that they put an entire zone behind, essentially, a secret. I mean, okay, it's not much of a secret, since most people, I'm sure, would eventually figure out to use the bubble. But you know, I mean, if that commenter hadn't said that, then I don't know if I would have made that connection. Because, I mean, it is different than every other zone. And every other zone... Well, actually, I don't know if that's true. Because in most of the zones, in most of the levels, I just went through the bell door. And I don't necessarily know if the other door leads to the same place or not. I assumed it did. But, you know, maybe not. Maybe I should think outside the box more. Oh, I see. Okay. Alley-oop. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, hey, those are like fire breakable blocks at the end there. I wonder if there was anything inside there. Alright, so what I want here is any power-up, basically. And I didn't get it. I got nothing. You will get nothing, good day, sir. Oh, there's only 2 levels in Space Zone, that's weird. I think that makes this the shortest zone yet. Oh no. That star is pissed. Those stars are pissed. Whoa! Oh my god, gravity is insane on this level! Holy crap! Can I just jump into deep space? What happens if I just keep going? Oh, I see. I hit the star ceiling. Makes sense. I like this music better than the last music. It's like a march almost. Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. It has that funky little breakdown there. Alright, so no VVVVVV style reverse gravity level, but this is almost as cool. Oh no. I know, there's no reason for me to get that, but I like to be thorough. I'm kinda surprised there's no keep a power-up with you mechanic in this game. Whether it's Mario 3 style, where you can apply the power-up on the world map, or Mario World style, where you have an extra power-up you can use in the level. I mean, since this came out pretty soon after Mario World, and that was a pretty big change from the previous games, I would have thought they would have kept that. But I mean, it's no big deal. Aw, oh, man. I wasn't sure if it was safe to get that or not. Oh, well. Oh, no. Oh, okay. I thought I wouldn't have a path this way. I was worried for a second. Aw, oh, man. I was hoping for a carrot. Oh, well. Oh, hey, it's that guy. It's that guy from the, it's the main boss of Mario Land. Mario Land 1. Wow. He just totally owned me. He just fed me a big steaming bowl of pone meal. Part of this nutritious extreme breakfast. Man, that sucked. Like, the jumping physics, I mean, it was still low gravity, so it was still very weird. Alright, so that still works. For some reason, I assumed that the endless float wouldn't work on the boss, but it does. So, all I have to do... is get pwned. Well, you know. I was still hungry for some pwned meal, so it's all good. And why are the stars so angry? What did I do to them? Wonder if they're related to the angry sun from Mario 3. Because, I mean, when you think about it, they're all the same thing. They're all stars. So, it's very possible that they're cousins. So, yeah, in Mario Land, I forget this guy's name. It's like Tortuga? Tortaga, something like that. But in Mario Land, it's very low resolution, so the sprite doesn't look like much of anything. I thought it looked kind of like Mighty Mon Jack, but when you look the enemy up in the instruction manual, it looks like that little alien goblin thing. Alright, well hopefully I get my shit together. This isn't going well. I'm not looking very elite at the moment. This kind of feels like a final level. I mean, theoretically, you could have gone to this level first, but this feels appropriate to do this level last. Wait. Can I go under those things? Those fireball things? I couldn't tell. I should try that because the strategy is not working out for me. But yeah, this definitely feels like a penultimate kind of boss. so I'm pretty sure you're expected to do this last. Okay, yeah, awesome. You can just duck under it. Of course, then you're not in a good position. Well, okay, maybe this will work. Aw, man. Yeah, see, you're not in a good position to jump on him. But this still seems safer than the alternative. Should probably stay back a little bit. Dang it. Alright, well, my spirits aren't broken yet. I've got this, it's just a matter of time. Of course, this isn't the last boss, I'm sure, not by a long shot. Because we still have Wario's castle to contend with. Or should I say Mario's castle. And I don't really know what that's going to entail. Not sure how big the final level is going to be. Or final zone. So it looks like as long as I stay like as far back as I can get. Okay, if I was actually as far over as I could have gone, then I probably wouldn't have gotten hit there. Alright, I think I have this figured out. See you later, Nebulon. Nobody likes your style. The sixth golden coin! Da-da-da-da! Alright, Wario. You son of a biscuit eater. I'm coming back to take what's mine. Tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you're having fun. I know I sure am. Tune in tomorrow for Wario's Castle. It's going to be very exciting. See you then.